check. He should have been here over an hour ago.
Mate.
Listen to that. I doubt if we'd even be able to find a place like this. Pass the bog, the roads are turned. That's what comes of living so far out.
Never mind, dear. Perhaps you'll win the next one.
That'll be him.
Sergeant Major Morris. When he went away, he was a slip of a youth in the warehouse. Now look at him.
You don't look to have taken much harm.
Where were you stationed, Sergeant Major?
Lhasa. Madras in the south. A couple of years with the garrison at Kabul.
I'd like to go to India myself someday. Just to look about a bit, you know.
Better where you are.
Matter of fact, I picked up this book. It's about India. I'll show you. It's got some good illustrations. Some good ones as well. Now, let's see. Whereabouts are we? Ah, here we are. The land of supreme marvels. Now, have a look through that, Morris. Bring back some old memories, eh? Yes. I'd love to see some of those old temples and jugglers and fakirs.
Fakirs?
Yes. Fakirs. Anyway, it's certainly a very strange part of the world. What's that you were telling me the other day about a monkey's paw or something?
Oh. It's nothing worth hearing.
Monkey's paw? What's that?
Well, it's just a bit of what you might call magic, perhaps.
Oh, good Lord.
Look at. It's just an ordinary little ball. Dried to a mummy.
And what's so special about it?
He had a spell put on it by an old fakir. A very holy man. He wanted to show that fate ruled people's lives. That those who interfered with it did so to their sorrow. Put a spell on it so that three separate men could each have three wishes from it.
Well, why don't you have three, sir?
I have.
And did you really have three wishes granted?
I did.
And has anybody else wished?
The first man had his three wishes. I don't know what the first two were. The third was for death. That's how I got the paw.
If you've already had your three wishes, it's no good to you now then, Morris. What do you keep it for?
Fancy, I suppose. I did have some idea of selling it, but I don't think I will. It has caused enough mischief already. Besides, people won't buy. I think it's a fairy tale, some of them. Those that do think anything of it want to try it first and pay me afterwards.
If you could have another three wishes, would you have them?
I don't know.
How'd you do it then, Morris?
Simply hold it in your right hand and wish out loud. Fire again like a sensible man. Very well. But don't blame me for what happens. If you don't mind, I'll have to be going, otherwise I'll miss that train.
Get your coat.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much. Good night, Major. Good night.
Good night.
Good night. For something sensible.
I don't know what to wish for, and that's a fact. Seems to me I've got all I want.
It all sounds like the Arabian Nights to me.
Well, why not wish for some money? Say, £200.
Oh, very well. I wish for £200. It moved. As I wished, it twisted in my hand like a snake.
Well, I don't see any money.
Must have been your fancy, Father.
Well, there's no harm done, but gave me a shock all the same.
Well, I think it's about time we were going up. Hey, Father.
I expect you'll find the cash tied up in a big bag in the middle of your bed. And something horrible, squatting upon the wardrobe, watching you as you pocket your ill-gotten gains.
Good night, Herbert. think of all that nonsense Morris came out with last night. Herbert and I had a hard time trying to restrain our laughter.
If you hadn't, Morris would have felt a right fool.
I suppose all old soldiers are the same. Arabian Nights nonsense. I mean, how could wishes be granted in this day and age? And if they could, how could £200 hurt you, Father?
Might drop on his head from the sky. Only one letter today. Doesn't look as though it contained £200. Might be a check, though.
Morris said things happen so naturally that you might, if you so wished, attribute it to coincidence.
Well, don't break into the money before I get back. I'm afraid it'll turn you into a mean, avaricious man. And we shall have to disown you.
Goodbye.
Well, what good fortunes has the post brought? Tailor's bill for your suit. 18 shillings and threepence. Mm-hmm. Herbert will have some more of his funny remarks, I expect, when he comes home.
I dare say. All that thing moved in my hand at that house.
I say it did. There is no thought about it. It actually moved. It may seem far-fetched to you, but the paw did come from India. There are numerous strange customs and tales in that book I showed Morris that you'd find hard to believe. An Indian, for instance, would not dare kick a cow to make it move because they believe that the animal possesses some sort of divine power, which makes them sacred. Naturally, their gods punish. What's the matter?
There, Mother, sit down and don't jump to conclusions. I'm sure you haven't brought bad news, sir.
I'm sorry.
Is he hurt?
Badly hurt. But he's not in any pain. Machinery.
Caught in the machinery.
Yes. The phone wishes me to express their sincere sympathy to you in your great loss. I hope you'll understand I'm only their servant and merely obeying orders. Say that Moore and Meggins disclaim all responsibility. They admit no liability whatsoever. But in consideration of your son's services, they wish me to present you with a certain sum as compensation.
Compensation? For how much?
£200.
father has gone out again today. He's finding it hard. I cannot any longer predict what he will do or when he will be back. It does not seem like 12 days since the burial. I wish I could not remember it so well. I never saw my son. Perhaps I could not have brought myself to look at him anyway. My last memory of him is watching him walk so briskly down the road to work. It was exactly a month before his 25th birthday. He had so little experience of life. Today I found myself setting the table for three. So silly. Once I nearly called him to come downstairs. The Reverend told me that he had rarely seen so many people paying their respects. He was always popular at the factory. Everybody liked him. Even Mr. Meggins came to the funeral, and he sent the largest and most beautiful wreath. It will be 3 months before we can place a stone at the head of the grave. Mr. Morton tells us that it will take that time for the earth to settle and harden. It saddens me to have to renew the flowers on a mound of earth. Do you still have it?
It's in the parlor, in the cabinet. Why?
I only just thought of it.
Thought of what?
The other two wishes. We've only had one. We've got two more left. Go down and get it quickly. And wish our son back alive.
Good God, are you mad? Wasn't one wish enough?
First wish granted. Why not the second?
Coincidence. Go back to sleep. You don't know what you're saying.
Oh, go and get it and wish.
But she's been dead 12 days. Besides, I was only able to recognize her by his clothing. If it was too terrible for you to see then, why, now?
Oh, bring him back. You think I fear the child I've nursed?
wish my son alive again.
It's all right now, dear. You'll be back.
Would you replace the oil, dear?